Welcome back to Android Open. I'm Alex Howard, and I'm here today with Steve Chin, the Chief Agile Methodologist at GXS. Welcome, Steve.
Hey, I'm very glad to be here today.
Awesome. So, you know more about Java than I'm probably ever going to come across. Like you've been studying it, working it, but this other thing is happening here. It's Adobe Flex, which is an open source technology, lets you create applications in ActionScript in XML. How is Flex changing what can be done on mobile?
So most people probably know about Flex technology from the initial offering was for browsers and desktop development. Air is the desktop equivalent, and Flash technology runs inside the browser. And you can use one of the API toolkits called Flex with it, which gives you a standard widget set, kind of like Swing or one of the other widget sets to build your application. One of the things which they did recently, which is really cool, and in my opinion, this is the leading edge of what you can do with mobile development, is they ported the Flex mobile technology to run on Android first, then BlackBerry, and they just released the iOS support. So now you can have a single code base for your application and deploy to three different platforms, and that's a game changer. I mean, you write your application once, ActionScript, MXML, hook it up to your Java backends or whatever web services you have, and then you can deploy your application across all the different mobile platforms that are currently of interest.
Got it. And right now we're mostly talking about, for tablets certainly, the iPad and then Android tablets, right?
Yeah, but tablets as well as smartphones. And they do really good things with density support. So you can target different form factor Android devices. And also you can figure out whether you're running on a tablet or a phone to do transitional apps which will scale and use the full screen real estate.
Now when you were working with Flex Mobile, is it any different than Flex elsewhere in the web?
They've expanded the APIs quite a bit. So Flex 4.5 includes a whole bunch of new APIs which give you, skinning for mobile controls, view navigator support, similar to what you'd see in an Android application. So they've expanded the support, but in essence, it's very similar if you've done Flex development for the desktop. It all transitions, and you can easily upgrade and port your applications to mobile.
So, speak of porting apps, what are some of the most interesting things you're seeing people build and deploy using Flex right now?
A lot of companies are doing for game development. That's very popular. Mm-hmm. If you think about what a lot of people do use Flex and Flash for today, if you have an existing application on trying to pull out of my hat. If you have an existing application on Facebook, you can take that and you can directly port that to a mobile device now. Hmm. If you have any web-based kids apps or social-based applications, you can deploy those to a phone. The Flash applications also transition nicely. In addition, I think there's a particular niche market for business applications. So if you think about your typical enterprise application, if you have an internal enterprise application, you want to get to as many platforms as possible so you can support it on different devices, but you don't have a full-time staff to create the iPhone app, the Android application, and provide the optimal experience for both of those. So this gives you a single technology platform where you can create your internal applications for business use and then deploy those across your entire customer base.
And I understand that there's an increasing amount of interest in the context of enterprise and government and using those kinds of smartphones.
Yeah,
and
it's just economics. I mean, it's a lot cheaper to develop the application once, and B, the Flash and Flex APIs it gives you much better rapid application development environments than coding up a native Android or iPhone app.
Now, in terms of some of the languages that you're working with, how are Jython, JRuby, and Scala changing mobile app development? And what do developers need to pay attention to there? And in that context, what's the story with Visage?
So this is kind of a different target. So what we've been talking up to now is cross-platform development. But one of the things specific to Android you can do if you're building a native Android application is, since it runs on the JVM, you directly translate. When you deploy applications to Android, you directly convert your JVM bytecodes into Dalvik bytecodes. So any language you could normally write for a Java virtual machine now translates directly over to what you can do on Android devices. And just recently, folks have been applying this to make it much easier to do Android development. So there was a talk earlier today on doing Scala on Android. You can take Scala, which is a great functional object-oriented programming language. Gives you type safety, gives you lots of shortcut syntax, great for writing DSLs. You can use that to build your Android application. I'm working on a language called Visage. It's another JVM language, formerly JavaFX script. It's built for writing UIs, has great bind syntax, has an object declarative syntax you can use to combine what you'd normally specify in XML and some of your Java logic and put that together in a single, unified, easier to maintain model and build your applications simpler using these JVM technologies. So I think what you're going to see is as more people adopt the Android platform and start applying technologies and development practices to streamline development, the use of JVM languages will be one of those things that becomes very common.
Great. So last question, and I'll just blue sky it. What are the biggest challenges that developers are facing in creating applications for Android right now?
With native Android application development, and I've heard this from several folks and experienced it myself as well, building clean, elegant user interfaces is not as easy as it could be. And I think this is one of the areas that really, if you look at the way Apple and other companies target their development, they target it more in the UI, less on the solid infrastructure and core APIs. Android has some very great APIs it sits on top of and some really strong technology. And what they really need to build out is a better UI stack for folks to easily and simply crank out good-looking applications.
Cool. Thanks, Steve.
Okay. Thank you.